behalf of everyone whose story could only be written in the greatest nation on earth, I accept your nomination to be President of the United States of America. What led me here in recent weeks was no doubt unexpected. But I'm no stranger to unlikely journeys. So my mother, our mother, Shamala Harris, had one of her own, and I miss her every day, and especially right now. And I know she's looking down smiling. My mother was a brilliant, 5-foot-tall, brown woman with an accent. And as the eldest child, I saw how the world would sometimes treat her. But my mother never lost her cool. She was tough, courageous, a trailblazer in the fight for women's health, and she taught Maya and me a lesson that Michelle mentioned the other night. She taught us to never complain about injustice, but do something about it. Do something about it. In many ways, Donald Trump is an unserious man. But the consequences of putting Donald Trump back in the White House are extremely serious. Consider the power he will have, especially after the United States Supreme Court just ruled that he would be immune from criminal prosecution. Just imagine Donald Trump with no guardrails. And how he would use the immense powers of the presidency of the United States. Not to improve your life, not to strengthen our national security, but to serve the only client he has ever had, himself. Fellow Americans, I love our country with all my heart. Everywhere I go, in everyone I meet, I see a nation that is ready to move forward, ready for the next step in the incredible journey that is America. So let's get out there. Let's fight for it. Let's get out there. Let's vote for it. And together, let us write the next great chapter in the most extraordinary story ever told. Thank you. God bless you, and may God bless the United States of America. Thank you all.